The human genome contains 3 billion letters, which are arranged into around 20,000 genes. During embryonic development, genes are constantly being switched on and off in a highly controlled and specific manner to create a complex organism containing millions of cells and many different organs. Failure in this process causes numerous diseases. But how do our cells know which genes to switch on and off, when, and in which parts of the body? To answer these questions, we can use the zebrafish to model what happens in humans. Why zebrafish? Because the zebrafish in humans have many of the same organs, such as the heart, brain, and pancreas, and many of the same genes. In fact, 70% of zebrafish genes are the same as human. Zebrafish are easy and inexpensive to grow and maintain, and one zebrafish couple can produce more than 200 offspring per week that grow 20 times faster than humans. Because we know the zebrafish genome sequence, researchers can create genetic changes in specific genes, or the switches that turn them on and off, which are known to be involved in human birth defects. We can even create zebrafish embryos that have fluorescent organs to study more easily how a genetic change impacts development using microscopy. These methods give us a way to understand the function of genes and their switches, and to develop new treatments for human genetic defects. To study how genes and switches are controlled, we can also use techniques called next-generation sequencing technology and bioinformatic analysis, collectively known as genomics. This allows us to determine where the switches are in the genome, which genes they control, whether they turn a gene on or off, and when during development the switch is active. We at the ZENCODE-ITN are using these advanced genomics techniques to discover how gene function is controlled during zebrafish development in order to better understand human development. We are a research network of 15 young researchers across Europe, funded by the European Commission under Horizon 2020 programme. We have partnered with DANIO-CODE Consortium to compile our findings in a database aiming to annotate the functional elements in the zebrafish genome. This knowledge will help us understand better how we function, and ultimately, it will allow us to develop better drugs and treatments for our patients.